OpenAI just announced their new AI model named Sora. This model allows you to create high-definition videos up to a minute long from just a prompt. People have been trying to make AI-generated videos for years, but without much success. Here's a video from about a year ago, generated by a model called Model Scope Text-to-Video of Will Smith eating spaghetti. Unsettling, isn't it? And more importantly, not realistic at all. Anyone can tell that this is an AI-generated video. Let's look at a couple of the videos that OpenAI Sora can generate. If I didn't tell you that these videos were AI generated, you might not even have noticed. We are seeing the creation of the Matrix. The research paper related to this model is titled Video Generation Models as World Simulators, and the last sentence literally says, "Our results suggest that scaling video generation models is a promising path towards building general purpose simulators of the physical world." I swear, once this tech gets even better, we're going to have virtual worlds where people can live any life that they dream of. Sora is able to create videos for different devices in almost any resolution. The highest resolution it can achieve right now is 1080p, which is the standard HD resolution. Sora is also able to take inputs like pre-existing images and video. This allows it to do video editing things like create a perfectly looping video, animate static images, extend videos backwards or forwards in time, and more. Here's an example of using an input image. You can see that Sora is provided an image of a Shiba Inu wearing a beret and a black turtleneck and is able to animate it pretty accurately. Another example of this is animating an image of a cloud that spells Sora. Extending generated videos. This is an example of how Sora can extend a generated video. Each of these three videos were extended backwards in time. Sora was provided an input video and then asked to extend the video backwards three different times. As a result of that, they all start differently but lead to the same ending. This method also allows you to seamlessly produce an infinitely looped video. Another capability of Sora is video-to-video editing. Provided an input video, Sora will change the output video based on your prompts. Here is an example of an input video of a Porsche driving down a road. The prompt asks it to change the setting to be in a lush jungle. Not only does Sora change the environment and lighting, it changes the car as well. Because Sora can change subjects and environments on the fly, it becomes easy to transition between videos. Instead of changing the video's surroundings, you can change the subject instead. This provides crazy transitions. Here's an example of a drone turning into a butterfly. While Sora is mainly used for video, it can also generate images up to a 2K resolution. Here are two images it was able to generate. These pictures look so real, I would never be able to tell it was AI generated. Simulate digital worlds. Sora is able to simulate video games as well, not just video. It can literally simulate Minecraft and move the player within. Imagine the video games that could come out of this technology. The research paper ends with a note. These capabilities suggest that the continued scaling of video models is a promising path towards the development of highly capable simulators of the physical and digital world, and the objects, animals, and people that live within them. Slowly, AI will take over the world. If you want to learn more about AI and be in a community of like-minded people, join my new Discord server, The AI Crowd. There are really no limits in the style it can generate. Animations, realistic, claymations, whatever you tell it to make, it will make it. Although this model is impressive, it does have some weaknesses. OpenAI states that it may struggle with accurately simulating the physics of a complex scene and may not understand specific instances of cause and effect. Let's look at a few examples of what that means. This prompt is a step printing scene of a person running. In this video, you can see that the person is running backwards. This motion is impossible in real life unless the treadmill was backwards. Here's another prompt. 5 gray wolf pups frolicking and chasing each other around a remote gravel road, surrounded by grass. The pups run and leap, chasing each other and nipping at each other playing. In this one, you can see that animals keep spawning out of nowhere, which is confusing and would never happen in a real situation. And here's another prompt. Basketball through hoop then explodes. In this example, while the basketball does go through the hoop and then explode, the physics are all wrong as you see the ball spawn back in and morph through the rim. So Sora currently exhibits numerous limitations as a simulator. An especially good example of this is glass breaking. You can see from this video that it just does not simulate this right. It looks like the glass turns to liquid. And this is another one of those little things that models first have trouble with. Just like the image generation AI sucked at generating hands and fingers, they eventually got fixed, so now that's accurate. So I'm sure this will get fixed as well. So what are the safety implications of models like Sora? Because they can generate such accurate and high definition video, it will be hard to tell what videos are real and which ones are fake as AI evolves. OpenAI says that they are working with domain experts in areas like misinformation, hateful content, and bias. They're also building tools to help detect misleading content, which already exists on platforms like TikTok and Instagram. Another thing they're doing is including metadata in the videos that are generated by Sora. But honestly, this can easily be deleted by someone. As you know, OpenAI blocks most prompts that request extreme violence, sexual content, or hateful imagery. Of course, this can be bypassed by jailbreaking prompts, so there's no doubt in my mind that someone will find a way to create nefarious videos with this model. By the way, if you want to discuss jailbreaking, you're safe to do so in my new Discord. So yeah, this is another model that OpenAI has made that is just crazy. I think as AI evolves, we will eventually have virtual worlds like The Matrix, or if you've ever seen like Ready Player One, movies like that where people just wear headsets and they live in this virtual world, ignoring their real physical life. Anyways, if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like and subscribe. Also, join my Discord again. And if you like videos like this and like content surrounding AI, make sure to stick around for the next one. Peace.